Hello, my name is Robert Dean Steele, and this is your daily Bible class. We've been talking about the parables of Jesus. This one here is a very interesting parable. It's Matthew chapter 13, verse number 15. He said to the owner of the house, he said there to them, "Therefore, the teacher of law has been instructed about the kingdom of heaven. It's like the owner of a house who brings out of his storehouse new treasures as well as old." Now, this is an interesting parable because basically he was talking to the owner of a house. And he said to them, "Do you understand? Therefore, every teacher of the law has been instructed." And the instruction is all about bringing good things into someone's life, bringing good teachings of the Word of God. You see, when you hear the Word of God, you will either get a good teaching or a bad teaching. And it all depends on the perspective of where the teacher is. If you have a teacher that knows God, and loves the Word of God, then what you're going to get is the unadulterated, unapologetic Word of God. Years ago, I was involved in a discussion with a whole bunch of liberal ministers. They'd asked me to come and join this particular discussion group. And we were discussing some scripture. And in the discussion, they were talking about things way out here. And I'm going, where is that coming from? Then I finally asked the question, do you believe in the Bible and what the Bible is? Do you believe the Bible is the inerrant Word of God? To my absolute shock and horror, there were 10 of us there. There were only two of us that believed that the Bible was the Word of God. Now, in my discussion, I said there, then why are we discussing this if you don't believe the Word of God is true? And you see, that's because they hadn't got the treasure and the wonderful thing that the Word of God is. That's what people have, when you have people standing behind the pulpit who do not know Jesus Christ, they're talking about philosophy. They're talking about moral things. They're talking about the latest, you know, craze. But they're not talking about the unadulterated, pure Word of God. What Jesus is saying is the kingdom of heaven is like the owner of a storehouse or a storeroom. He has new treasures and old treasures. What he's doing is he's constantly seeking to find new treasures. And that's what the Word of God is. You know, every day, you and I can go to the Word of God. And we can receive the Word of God. We have a value in the Word of God. You know, Jesus said, "Man does not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes or proceeds from the mouth of God." The Word of God is literally the thoughts, the ideas that have been written down about the Lord. But it was the Holy Spirit that, as Peter said, men were literally carried along by the Spirit of God, and they wrote what the Holy Spirit gave them. You see, every day we can have a new treasure as well as the old established treasure of the Word of God. The whole thing is that we have to view the Word of God and our relationship with God and the kingdom of heaven with righteousness, peace, and joy, kingdom of God, as a treasure of great value. And we must view it that way because that's what it is. We have been given a wonderful opportunity, a wonderful treasure, a wonderful life, eternal and abundant life, and we need to value it for what it is. And that's what Jesus was trying to get across. He says, when you have this treasure, it's both new and old. It's new because the Bible says the mercies of God are new every morning. And yet it is also old because it stands from the foundation of the world. God himself is the author of the book. And we need to view it for how it is, a priceless, wonderful gift given to us, a treasure in storehouse. And did you also know that you're a treasure as well? The Bible says that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Don't ever devalue yourself. Understand this, that you are a treasure in earthen vessels. That's what Paul said. So today, enjoy who you are and enjoy what you've been given. and continually spend time with the Lord, reading His Word, and every day receive a new treasure, a new insight, a new knowledge of what you have been given and why you've been given it. My name is Robert Dean Steele. This is your daily Bible class. You have yourself a great and godly day.